I'm Abhishek and today we're going to discuss the Mahindra eSupro. We showcased the electric van Mahindra's eSupro a few months ago on this channel. Many of you liked the concept of an electric van, but many others were wary about the high price. Now, every business is different, with each having different goods transportation or people transportation needs. We received many queries from business owners about whether the eSupro was a viable electric vehicle for their specific use cases. So, in this video, we are going to crunch some numbers and talk to a few business owners and obtain their perspectives. Now, this business transports 4 tons or 4,000 kilograms of goods per day. It transports raw materials to a factory and hauls the finished goods to the transport office. It does this every day, so this is a perfect use case for an electric van. We will compare the Mahindra eSupro with diesel MOVs like Tata Ace Zip or Mahindra Supro's diesel version. Each vehicle has a payload capacity of around 600 kilograms. The following are the numbers for this business. Goods coming in per day, 800 kilograms in batches of 2. Distance traveled, 30 kilometers per trip. Total number of trips, 2. Total distance, 60 kilometers. Time, 8 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. The goods going out per day is 2,400 kilograms in batches of 4. Distance traveled is 20 kilometers per trip. Total number of trips is 4. Total distance is 80 kilometers and time is 6:30 p.m. to 7 p.m. Now, regarding the diesel vehicle, the total number of trips per day is 6. Fuel stops is 1. Total kilometers traveled per day is 150. Total diesel consumed per day is about 10 liters. The total cost of diesel is Rs. 690 at 69 rupees per liter. Per month is about Rs. 17,250. So, fuel cost per annum is about 2,07,000. Maintenance cost per year is Rs. 25,000. Annual operation cost, fuel and maintenance is Rs. 2,32,000. Now, regarding the eSupro, total number of trips per day is 6. AC charge overnight and AC charge all day in order to charge the car. Total kilometers traveled per day is 150 kilometers. Total electricity consumed per day is 16 units. Total cost of electricity is Rs. 160 at 10 rupees per unit at commercial places. Days of operation is 25 days. Total electricity consumption per month is 4,000 units, that's in kilowatt hours. Fuel, that is electricity cost per month is Rs. 4,000. Fuel cost per annum is Rs. 48,000. Maintenance per year is Rs. 8,000. Annual operation cost, fuel and maintenance is Rs. 56,000. So, an eSupro, as you can see, if used intelligently, can save your business a lot of money each year. You can save 1,76,000 per year and a whopping 8,80,000 in 5 years. Even if some electrical component has to be replaced after the 3-year warranty, you're still saving more than 8 lakh rupees. Also note that diesel prices tend to fluctuate and can go up or down. Electricity prices, meanwhile, are very stable, so you can be assured of savings. Now, unfortunately, there are some limitations. The lack of quick charging affects how flexible you can be with the eSupro. If you want to travel more than 180 kilometers in a day, the lack of quick charging becomes a problem. Additionally, if you have to make an unscheduled delivery, you'll face a problem. At the same time, if you need to travel only 150 kilometers and you know your schedule in advance, then an eSupro can be truly valuable for your business. Now, let's speak to a few business owners, show them these numbers and hear what they have to say.
Throughout the day, approximately with purchase and sales, it's around 3 to 4 tons. We need sugar. We buy from market, so at one time there is 1 ton coming, but it's falling short of it. We need a second vehicle coming. And while goods are being processed and they are dispatched into the market or the transports, so that's again maybe a 2-3 around. If it's a rental vehicle, we spending 2,400 in a day on rent, paying rent. And then if it's our own vehicle, since we don't have a driver, we spend 2,400. If we have a driver, we pay him salary, as well as we approximate kilometers that happens is around more than 125, 140 kilometers. So we spend around 650 to 700 rupees per day operating cost. And this is how the business runs. So I've seen these numbers and they're very impressive. Around 150 kilometers, 140 kilometers is also my requirement. And there's a lot of saving. I mean, it's so surprising, you know, like I can save around 1.75 lakhs per month just on transportation. Per annum, such a saving is valuable for a person like me. The best part is we're also saving the carbon. So maybe along the time in 5 years, it shows an average of 9 lakh rupees saving. I would count around 6 lakh rupees of saving. Still, it's big, you know. So it's very impressive. So looking at an option for eSupro, and I tried to find out more options. I spoke to company man from Kinetic, and they also have an interesting product called Safar Shakti. Yeah, Safar Shakti is a beautiful product. It has a load capacity that's 480 kgs. It's a three-wheeler, but the range is just 70 kilometers. It's a lithium ion, and it's very cost effective in pricing also. So I have an option. I'm looking forward for one of them to be, you know, selected for my purpose. So if I can charge it within 2 hours, they say you can full charge in 2 hours. So that suffices my requirement. Within 2 hours, I can full charge it. Like, so in morning trips, when my purchase is done, till 12:30 it's over, there's a lunch time, and then there is the other period, the vehicle is lying idle till 4 o'clock. That's ample of time to get it charged completely for 70 kilometers further trip. So two trips I can give back. So I mean, Kinetic is also having a good option. So I need to see which is better, which suits us. But eSupro Cargo has a fixed whole body. So that is also a plus point, because in rainy season we'll be having real advantage on eSupro Cargo. And eSupro Cargo gives very good driving comfort. So now I'm going to take trials for both and evaluate, and going for one EV cargo vehicle. And I would thank PluginIndia for this. Thank you, PluginIndia.
I'm here in Santa Cruz speaking to Mr. Ashish. Mr. Ashish owns a hotel in Santa Cruz. Now, I should clarify that Mr. Ashish does not require a cargo van as much as he requires a passenger van. I let him explain why. Ashish, welcome.
Hi, thank you.
First, tell me a little about your business.
Right, so we are a business hotel at Santa Cruz Hotel Accord, that is near the airport, and it's just about 3 kilometers away, and the international is like 5 kilometers away. So every day we have at least 6 or 7 drops and pickups for the guests who come and stay with us. It would be awesome if I could do that in an environmentally friendly way, right? So I needed a van which had enough space and storage, and I need at least 6 people to be transported, or 5 people to be transported from our hotel to the airport, right? We spend a lot on fuel as it is. With our diesel cars that we require.
Right, I can imagine.
Yeah. And the electric cars are just not big enough for luggage. Because our luggage requirements are quite massive. Some of our guests travels with 7 large suitcases.
Wow.
Yeah, they don't care about the emissions, right? So, I mean, we require these electric vans or vehicles to transport these passengers. So that is why I'm looking for an electric vehicle.
Okay.
For the very same purpose.
Right. Okay, Ashish, I believe you own an Omni.
Right, that's right.
Yeah. So can you tell me a little about how much it costs you in fuel per month, and how much does it cost you in maintenance per year?
Right. So, I mean, we have about 12 round trips from the airport every day, almost at an average. That would come up to cost about 18 to 20,000 a month, and about 25,000 to 35,000 rupees a year in maintenance.
Okay, that's a lot.
And that's just basic maintenance.
Yeah.
There's lots more that can go wrong, you know, like
an
oil leak can cause our expenses to go up.
Yeah. And it's a petrol car, I'm guessing?
Yes, it's a petrol car.
Yeah. So lots of components, anything can go wrong at any time.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. And even in the fluctuation with fuel, so these numbers can vary a lot.
Fuel prices, you
mean. Yeah.
Right. Okay. Now, Ashish, I have some data here that I'd like you to take a look at. And then after that, I want to know what your thoughts are. Okay, so now that you've taken a look at this data, can you tell me, would you like to swap out your petrol Omni for an electric van?
Most definitely. This would make absolute sense for me, and I have a little bit space for solar power as well, right?
Right, wow.
So if I get that on solar power, it'll be fantastic. Zero emissions, right. And
zero costs.
Exactly. And I would love to boast it as being one of the first hotels in India to have solar-driven cars for the airport pickup and drop.
Right.
I would provide free service. Not that we charge for it, but I would provide it for free otherwise.
Right, magnificent. Okay, Ashish, thanks a lot for your time.
Thank you.
And I'm hoping that you will buy your electric van soon.
Definitely. But I can't choose the Supro because it does not have air conditioning. Although it has the passenger variant.
Right.
But they do not have air conditioning, and I would not want to go to a third party dealer who would give me an air conditioning unit, which would void my warranty with Mahindra.
Right.
Right. So I would not take any risk voiding my warranty for an electric vehicle, where the electronics are the most expensive and the most important part of the car.
So what you're saying is that for a passenger van, an AC is must.
Oh yes, for the passenger comfort, it is definitely required in this Mumbai pollution.
Okay, great. Thanks a lot, Ashish, for your input.
Thank you.
And best of luck.
Thank you.
Yeah. So, as you just heard from real business owners who are transporting real goods, the e-Supro can definitely help their businesses, albeit with some limitations. Do you own a business? Do you transport goods regularly? Would an electric van make sense to you? Please let us know in the comments. We read every comment and we try to respond to as many as possible. And if you like this video, please be sure to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.